on the draw, this is our hand. I've got an Ingenious Scavenger Prey upon, which is decent enough, and an Emrakul's Evangel in case I draw Primal Druid, so seems solid. Looks like I drew another island, so that probably will get discarded, the Pack Guardian. I'm playing the green-blue mirror. Okay. Now we can curve Scob and a Pack Guardian, which is decent. A 2-1. I guess this actually we can get Delirium in our deck because of Pack Guardian. I thought there was no ways to get lands in our graveyard. Pretty hard for us to get Delirium though. All right, so here I could replay the Scob, or I could just hold up Pack Guardian. That could just not attack if I just play the land, because that pretty much signals that I have some sort of instant. That being said, well, I guess it's not even that good if I play the Pack Guardian, because I have to trade off the token for Furtive Homunculus if they attack that way, so I probably should just play the Scob. Just holds off all these creatures. I could have preyed upon the Quilled Wolf last turn. I'm sort of getting pressure now, and they're going to have mana up for it next turn. So I think I should use... I should play the Scob here. And prey upon the Quilled Wolf. And then just play Cask of Dire Swine into Pack Guardian later. Plus they're tapped out now, which is a good time to do this. But we are already at 10. They've delivered the beatdown. If I attack in prowess, they'll probably just kill my guy. Could you play Cask of Dire Swine Go? That way they can't attack. And that sets up Prey Upon. I think that's good. They don't get a good use of their 3 mana this turn on the apparatus. So, I think attack with both. And then probably prey upon post-combat. This will also flip soon. In fact, flips literally next turn into a 4-6. So, what's my plan here? They have no cards in hand, though. I'm a man away from just casting this, so, I could just prey upon here, because a 4-6 is way harder to defeat than a 4-4. If I prey upon here, they can either trade... chump, and then I have Pack Guardian just block. They'd probably just take a bunch of damage, right? The 4-3 gets to trade. I think this is good. both. Probably just take it all. Alright, never mind, they're jumping. Okay, well, if they're doing that, then I think I'd still just hold a Pack Guardian. Need an insect and trade for the apparatus. Otherwise I play a Vandal and it just dies to the apparatus. Pack Guardian can turn on Delirium too, which is nice once I draw an instant. Or not, yeah, once I draw an instant after the land. If I draw a land, I'll just play the Retrogriff. If not, play that. Could also take one and just attack for four. It's interesting. Blocking might not even be good with the 4-3. I could just play the Pack Guardian and attack for 10 next turn and just let them have that up. It's probably actually the best. Don't play this at all. And just race. Because the 3-4 is so good on this board. Play Identity Thief here. Really don't think this card is all that good. Although it is a nice combo with It of the Horde Swarm. Because it makes insects, so you can upgrade them into 3/2s. Okay. So for this matchup, opponent has a bunch of creatures all across the board of power and toughness. Prey upon still works pretty well. I could board in Geist-Fueled Scarecrow, potentially. Don't really know that I need to. These Primal Druids already really help hold the fort early. I have enough big creatures that I think can go over the top with Prey Upon, so... Though, trading this for the Evangel seems okay, because the Druid's already quite good, and still combined with the Wretched Griff. I think making that swap is okay. The 3-2 is just going to trade down otherwise. And in a green mirror, having another big creature for Prey Upon seems pretty good. This hand's fine. Sombrald Stag is a good answer to Geist. So I draw an island, this just gets to attack into the Geist. So just take the damage. Pack Guardian also just attacks through this. And I want to play my lands anyway, so I'm just gonna Pack Guardian here. I don't want to play the Scarecrow yet, because I really just want to get the Stag down next turn. So there we have Jace's Scrutiny. So just attack with both. Scrutiny this. And I can either crack my clue, or I can deal a point of damage. I think cracking the clue is better so that I can play Stag next turn, most likely. Do that now in case I draw land. Didn't. Kept a card on top there. If we don't draw land, I don't know what our plan's going to be. So they just gone missing there? Sure. Interesting block. I was debating, you know, replaying the Pack Guardian or not there anyways. Now my Somberwald's Day gets to just trade with the next thing. Okay. Plus, this was going to be able to flip with Pack Guardian. Guess I'll still just play Pack Guardian. Strange they didn't try to ambush and trade and just wanted to take four. Could indicate a combat trick here. I should just play this in response in case they want to draw into a counterspell. Well, they know I Pack Guardian, and it's not like I'm really getting a ton of value off of it by holding it. Like, the only downside of this is that I can't randomly pump my Ingenious Scott, but I don't think that matters too much. I attack with both of these, they can block here and block there. So I can attack with this too, because it could just trade across. So that's what I'll do. And then if my opponent blocks, I can just play the captive. So most likely though, it's... Okay, they're going for that line, sure. So pump twice and play a captive. That was a good answer. But I drew the land, so... Two can play at that game.